Hi guys, welcome to another video. So in this video, I'll show you guys how you can show different content based on different countries. So if you have created markets within Shopify and you want to show a section or several products on different markets, then you can use this tutorial as a guide. I have created a tutorial previously on in which I showed you guys how you can show different pricing on different country. So that was just for the pricing of the product. But in this video, I'll go in detail on how you can create sections separately for a separate market. And I'm going to give you some of the code example, which is from the Shopify blog itself. And I'm also going to show you guys an easy way on how you can do that within Customize. So if you want to learn, stick to the video. Don't forget to subscribe the channel because that will help me and my team create more valuable content for you guys. So make sure to subscribe and hit the bell icon so you can get notified whenever we create new helping videos for you guys. So without further ado, let's get into the screen. So guys, in order to show different content for different market, first we'll have to set up market within our Shopify settings. And I'm going to show you how you can set different markets. So in this example, in this particular example, we will create a separate market for a European country. And let's say we create a new market for Spain. And then I'm going to show you guys how you can use Liquid and display specific content for that market and how you can display some of the products on a market of Spain only, right? So that's the blog post of Shopify itself where you can learn about it. And I'm going to use examples from this blog post, and they have given us the Liquid code examples where I'm going to use this if localization country Liquid check to show different content based on the market. And at the end of this video, I'm also going to show you guys how you can do that really easily with the Customize, so you don't have to learn any Liquid. But let's watch this and let me show you guys how you can do that. Okay, so first let's go to the back end of this development store and set up the market for the country called Spain. Okay guys, so that's the dashboard, and now click on settings. And from our settings, we are going to click on markets. And here you can see the default market is United States. What we're going to do, we'll click on add market. And then we'll search for the country which we are looking for. I'm going to name my market Spain. And then from this here, click on this search and filter. And then type the country you want to type or you want to add in. Checkmark this and click on add market. Okay, we have our market added. Great. Now we can add products and pricing specifically for this market. I've already shown you guys how you can do that. Link it will be in the description where I showed you guys how you can show different pricing based on market. But for this tutorial, I'm going to show you guys how you can basically create different sections based on the market, right? So our market is active already, and we are going to translate it. We are going to add language. So click on languages and domain. And here we are going to click on add languages. And for that, we will first need to add and manage our subdomains for this language. So click on this use subfolders or domains slash subdomains. And here we are going to select this use subfolder. And here we have this mentioned here. You can also use a separate domain if you want to use a separate domain, but we don't have domain. So I'm just going to use subfolder in this example. Click on save. And now let's click on add languages again. And now we are seeing this option here, Spanish. Let's click on that. And now you can see our language is added. Now, when I click on these three small dots, I'm seeing this option of localize, where it's basically going to install an app which is available freely in Shopify. So let's click on that. And here it will take us to translate and adopt. So that's basically a free app by Shopify. I already had this installed on my development store, but you can install that. You can simply go to Shopify App Store and search for Translate and Adapt. I'm going to show you guys here. And that's the app which I'm talking about. You can see pretty good ratings because it's a free app from Shopify itself through which you can translate your whole store without any manual interference. It's going to do that automatically, right? So as you can see it here, it's asking us to edit the translation of Spanish language. So let's click on edit Spanish translations. And here we are just going to click on auto translate. So it will translate all of the English content on our store to Spanish. So let's click on auto translate. Click on translate button again. And now you can see that it automatically added all of the translation. Cool, right? Now let's go back. And here we have our English version URL for the Spain market. And this is the Spanish language for the Spain market. Now, ideally, you would want to show the Spanish version when someone clicks on the country Spain. And I'm also going to show you guys how you can add a country selector to your header or footer. So let's select Spanish as a default in the market of Spain. Okay, let's click on these three small dots and then click on set as default. Now it's going to show this Spanish version when someone switched to the country Spain. Now let's check out our store by hitting refresh that if it's added the drop down of country selector or not. So let's hit refresh. Now you can see that we have these two countries showing up on the drop down in header and in footer as well. We have these drop down showing up. Now in US market, we have not added any language. So if we go back to markets and click on United States and then click on languages and domains, we just have English language. But in Spain market, we have two languages. So if we click on Spain and languages, we have English and Spanish version. So let's switch to Spain. And now you can see we also have language selector showing up where we have Espanol, which is Spanish, and English version. So you can see our product title and everything has been changed as per the Spain market. And if we switch back to English language, we can see everything in English. You can change most of the part in language from translate and adopt. Now I wanted to show you guys how you can show different content based on different market, right? So that's the blog post. I'm going to link that in the video description. So first we will start with the basic, where we will show some content based on market selected. So let's go to our theme customize. And from there, I'm going to click on customize. And here I'm going to add a custom liquid. So click on add section. And here we have the option of adding custom liquid. Now let's add H3 for Spain market and another H3 for our United States markets. So I'm adding a basic heading here. This content is for Spain market. And now let's copy that, add another heading, and this content is for USA market, right? Now all we have to do is just add an if condition, which is shown up here. So I'm going to copy this if condition where it basically adding a check and checking if the country ISO code is matching FR. So you can find the localization or country ISO codes from Google. So if you Google country ISO codes, So here are the list of country ISO codes. In our case, the country ISO code is ES. So if we search here Spain, you can see that the ISO code is ES, right? So that's our country ISO code. So let's copy this if condition and then add it here. And for the localization ISO code, we're going to add ES. And now we are going to add an else after this content here. So let's add an else. and then add in another end if condition. Because we are ending the if statement. Okay, now you can see that it's now only showing the content for USA market and not the Spanish market. So let's click on save and check out from the front end. And now hit refresh. And here we have this showing up that we are on the Spain market, right? Now let's switch back to our United States market. And now it's telling you that this content is for USA market. Now it's a pretty basic example, but I wanted to give you more understanding on how you can use this if condition to add specific content for specific market, right? Now, let me give you guys a little advanced explanation of how we can use that. So I want to disable the add to cart button for the Spanish market, or yeah, let's do that for Spain market. I want to disable the add to cart button and I don't want any of the customers from Spain to add product to the cart or buy the product, right? We can use that really easily. So let me show you how we can do that. So there are examples available for that as well. So you can see they have given example of how you can do that. I'm going to show you guys how you can make it work out in Dawn 15.0.2, which is the latest version. So I'm going to open the code editor. In code editor, the add to cart button is located in buy-buttons.liquid. So let's search for buy-buttons, search the file buy-buttons.liquid. And in this file, if we scroll down, in line number 88, we can add an additional statement in within the if condition to check if the country ISO code is ES, then it's going to disable that add to cart button. Now let me show you how we can do that. So I'm just going to hit enter. Within this if condition, we are going to add additional or, and let's add localization dot country dot ISO code equals to ES. So now it's going to check if the localization ISO code is equals to ES, then it's going to disable our add to cart button. Now let's check that on our live version. So click on save. And it's going to take a few seconds. So I might have to refresh a couple of times in order to see if it's working properly. So currently we are on US market. We are now going to the Spain market. And now you can see that our buttons are disabled. But if we go back to the US market, we can easily add product to the cart. So if I click on add to cart, I can add product to the cart. But if I go to the Spain market, I'm unable to add product to the cart or even click on buy it now. So that's how we can play with this localization if condition. And again, I'm going to put this link in the description so you can check that out. By the way, if you have watched this video till yet, I'm going to add in some additional freebies for you guys. So first of all, if you are new to Shopify and you want to set up a new store, there's a link in the description through which you can sign up for a free 3-day trial and you'll be getting your store for just $1 a month. Additionally, I have created multiple other tutorials to help improve the layout of your store. So that's the development store where I'm going to show you guys what are the sections which you can find out if you subscribe to this channel. So you can see I have created this transparent header. When you hover over, it gives you a gray background. You can add all of these features, all of this transparent header feature to your Shopify store. Subscribe to this channel. You will find a lot of other videos. And you can also see that this video is continuously playing on our to loop. And this feature is also not available in default free themes. You might find these features in the paid theme, but you won't be getting that in the free themes, which I'm going to provide you guys for completely for free. And if you check out the menu, it's a cool looking mega menu in which I have added this GIF animations. You can add these all cool features to your store completely for free. All you have to do is just subscribe the channel and you will also find the link in the description for the video. Okay, now let's proceed. Now we have disabled the add to cart button. Now I'm going to show you guys an easier way on how you can display sections based on market, which is through customize, and it's super easy, which you can do that. So let's go back to customize. And so these are my sections, and here I have the option to select the market, right? So let's click on that market, and now I'm going to go to the Spain market. And here you can see we have the option add section to Spain. Now I can add section just to the Spain market, and if I add any section to Spain, it's only going to show if someone is visiting the Spain market. So let's check out one of the example. So I'm going to add image with text. Yes, click on continue. I want to override default section order. And now I'm going to add the heading for this is, this section is for Spain. Perfect. Now let's click on save. And you can see that this green small dot which is showing up, and it's just for this specific market. Now if I go back and hit refresh, you can see that this image with text section is showing up now. But if I switch the market to United States, it's not gonna show that section. Cool, right? So it's a super simple way where you can create customized template based on the market chosen by the visitor. And that's it for the video, guys. I wanted to show you guys this, some of the tricks which you can implement to sell better on different markets. You might want to show different pricing on different markets. Again, I've already created a video for that. Link will be in the description. And you, from this video, you have learned how to create different sections for different countries. Until next video, have a great day.